Our objectives in this lesson are the following. Estimate the square root of a whole number to the nearest hundreds and plot irrational numbers on a number line. Let's have a quick activity on our previous lesson. What's my estimated value? Number 1 is square root of 55. To answer this, let us bring out our perfect square table. 55 is somewhere in between 49 and 64. So this means square root of 55 is less than the square root of 64, which is 8, but greater than the square root of 49, which is 7. Number 2 is square root of 150. 150 is somewhere in between 144 and 169. So square root of 150 is less than the square root of 169, which is 13, but greater than the square root of 144, which is 12. Last one is square root of 350. 350 is somewhere in between 324 and 361. So square root of 350 is less than the square root of 361, which is 19, but greater than the square root of 324, which is 18. This time, we are going to estimate the square roots of whole numbers to the nearest hundreds. Let's have the first example, a square root of 14. The first thing that I'm going to do is to plot this on a number line. 14 is here. And then I'm going to think of the two closest perfect squares to 14. And those are 16 and 9. So a square root of 14 is less than a square root of 16, but greater than a square root of 9, since 14 is in between 9 and 16. A square root of 9 is 3, a square root of 16 is 4. So a square root of 14 is less than 4, but greater than 3. Now, I'm going to look for the distance of 9 and 16 from 14. From this graph, you will notice that 14 is closer to 16 than to 9. So it means a square root of 14 is closer to 4 than to 3. Now, I'm going to square numbers with one decimal place that is closer to 4, but not greater than 4. These numbers are 3.5, so we have 3.5 squared, 3.6 squared, 3.7 squared, 3.8 squared. Since this is already beyond 14, then I don't need to get 3.9 squared. By the way, we don't need to get 3.1 squared, 3.2 squared, 3.3 squared, and 3.4 squared because we are looking for numbers closer to 4 than to 3. Now, if you are going to ask me how did I solve these numbers, I simply multiply the number by itself. 3.5 squared is equal to 3.5 times 3.5. You may refer to our previous lesson on multiplying decimals. Now, I'm going to determine the two closest numbers to 14, and those are 13.69 and 14.44. I'll repeat the process. I'll plot this on a number line. First, I'll plot again 14, and then I have 14.44, and then 13.69. Then I will get the distance of 13.69 and 14.44 from 14. From this graph, you will see that 14 is closer to 13.69 than to 14.44. Since this is closer to 13.69, then I am going to square this time the numbers with two decimal places closer to 3.7. These are 3.71, 3.72, 3.73, 3.74, 3.75. Once again, we do not need to square 3.76, 3.77, 3.78, and 3.79 because we are looking for numbers closer to 3.7 than to 3.8. Now, I'm going to look again for the numbers closest to 14, and these are 13.9876 and 14.0625. Then I will decide Which one of this is closer to 14? 13.9876 is closer to 14 than 14.0625. Therefore, the square root of 14 is equal to 3.74. If you want to check, get your calculator and input square root of 14. Let us see. Square root of 14 is equal to 3.74. Again, we are rounding off to the nearest hundredths, so up to 2 decimal places. So our answer, 3.74, is correct. Let us have another example, square root of 70. Now, square root of 70 is somewhere in between the square root of 64 and 81. So it means square root of 70 is less than the square root of 81, but greater than the square root of 64. The square root of 64 is 8. The square root of 81 is 9. So square root of 70 is less than 9, but greater than 8. Obviously, 70 is closer to 64 than 81. So it means square root of 70 is closer to 8 than to 9. So I'm going to square numbers with one decimal place closer to 8. These are 8.1 squared, 8.2 squared, 8.3 squared, 8.4 squared. Since this is beyond 70, then I don't need to get 8.5 squared. Now, I don't need to get 8.6 squared, 8.7 squared, 8.8 squared, and 8.9 squared because I am looking for numbers closer to 8 than to 9. Now, I'm going to decide which numbers are closest to 70, and these are these two numbers here. Now, I'm going to decide which one is closer to 70. Instead of plotting this on a number line, I will just subtract. 70 minus 68.89 is 1.11. 70.56 minus 70 is 0.56. From here, I could say that 70.56 is closer to 70 than 68.89 because the difference is much smaller than this one. This time, I'm going to square numbers with two decimal places that are closer to 8.4 but not beyond 8.4. These are 8.35 squared, 8.36 squared, 8.37 squared. 8.37 squared is 70.0569. This is beyond 70 already. So I don't need to get 8.38 squared and 8.39 squared. So these are the two numbers closest to 70. I'm going to determine which one is closer. I will no longer plot this on a number line. I will just subtract. 70 minus 69.8896 is 0.1104. 70.0569 minus 70 is 0.0569. Which one has a smaller difference? This one. So this means 70.0569 is closer to 70 than 69.8896. So therefore, square root of 70 is equal to 8.37. Let us check using your calculator. Square root of 70 is 8.3666 and so on. Nearest hundredths, so up to 2 decimal places. Since 6 is greater than 5, then we're going to round off this 6 to 7. 8.37. Let us have one more, square root of 300. 300 is somewhere in between 289 and 324. So square root of 300 is less than the square root of 324 but greater than the square root of 289. The square root of 324 is 18 and the square root of 289 is 17. Now, I'm going to determine the distance of 289 and 324 from 300. 300 minus 289 is 11. 324 minus 300 is 24. Which one has a smaller difference? This one. So this means the square root of 300 is closer to 17 than to 18. Next step is to square numbers closer to 17 than to 18. So these are 17.1 squared, 17.2 squared, 17.3 squared, 17.4 squared. Since this is already greater than 300, then I don't need to get 17.5 squared. So the numbers that are closest to 300 are these numbers. Let us see which one is closer to 300. 300 minus 299.29 is 0.71. 302.76 minus 300 is 2.76. A smaller difference means 300 is closer to that number. So, a square root of 300 is closer to 17.3. Now, I'm going to square numbers with two decimal places closer to 17.3 than to 17.4. So, these are 17.31 squared, 17.32 squared, 17.33 squared. Since this is already greater than 300, no need to get 17.34 squared and 17.35 squared. So these are the numbers closest to 300. Let us find out which one is closer. 300 minus 299.9824 is 0.0176. 300.3289 minus 300 is 0.3289. The smaller difference is 0.0176. So it means the square root of 300 is equal to 17.32. Go on, check it in your calculator. The square root of 300 is 17.32. We are correct. Now, let us plot irrational numbers on number line. Let us recall our example earlier, is square root of 14. Is square root of 14 again is less than is square root of 16 but greater than is square root of 9? Or is square root of 14 is less than 4 but greater than 3? Let us have the number line. Since 14 is closer to 16 than to 9, then is square root of 14 is closer to 4 than to 3. Here is 3, here is 4. Let us plot a point closer to 4 than to 3. This is a square root of 14. Another example that we had is a square root of 70. And this is less than a square root of 81, but greater than a square root of 64. Or a square root of 70 is less than 9, but greater than 8. Since obviously 70 is closer to 64 than to 81, then a square root of 70 is closer to 8 than to 9. Let's have our number line. Here is 8 and here is 9. Let us plot a point closer to 8 than to 9. This is a square root of 70. Let us have an activity. Plot me. Letter A is square root of 20. The two closest perfect square numbers to 20 are 16 and 25. The square root of 16 is 4. The square root of 25 is 5. Now let us have the number line. Take a look at this. The difference of 20 and 16 is 4. The difference of 25 and 20 is 5. It means 20 is closer to 16 than to 25. So, a square root of 20 is closer to 4 than to 5. Let us create a point that is closer to 4 than to 5. This is a square root of 20. Next one is square root of 88. The two closest perfect square numbers to 88 are 81 and 100. The square root of 81 is 9. The square root of 100 is 10. Now let us see where 88 is closer to. The difference of 88 and 81 is 7. The difference of 188 is 12. So it means 88 is closer to 81. Therefore, the square root of 88 is closer to 9 than to 10. Let's plot it on the number line. Here is 9 and here is 10. Let us create a point closer to 9 than to 10. This is a square root of 88. For the summary, here are the steps in estimating the square roots of a whole number to the nearest hundreds. Now, it is time to check your understanding. Pause this video for more time. Let us answer. Estimate square root of 115 to the nearest hundreds and plot it on a number line. Let's have our perfect square table. 115 is somewhere in between 100 and 121. So, square root of 115 is less than the square root of 121 but greater than the square root of 100. The square root of 100 is 10. The square root of 121 is 11. So, square root of 115 is less than 11 but greater than 10. Now, let us determine the distance. The distance from 115 to 100 is 15. The distance from 121 to 115 is 6. So, it means 115 is closer to 121 than to 100. So, square root of 115 is closer to 11 than to 10. Now, we are going to square numbers with one decimal place that is closer to 11, but not greater than 11. So, these are 10.5 squared, 10.6 squared, 10.7 squared, 10.8 squared. Since this is already greater than 115, then I don't need to get 10.9 squared. Now I will decide which among these numbers is closer to 115. Let us see. 115 minus 114.49 is 0.51. 116.64 minus 115 is 1.64. This one has a smaller difference. So, 114.49 is closer to 115. So, a square root of 115 is closer to 10.7 than to 10.8. Now, I'm going to square numbers with two decimal places that are closer to 10.7 than to 10.8. So, these are 10.71, 10.72, 10.73. This is already greater than 115. So, I don't need to get 10.74 and 10.75. Now, which among these numbers is closer to 115? Let us see. 115 minus this number is 0.0816. 115.1329 minus 115 is 0.1329. This one is smaller, so it means 115 is closer to 114.9184. Therefore, a square root of 115 is equal to 10.72. Now, let us plot it on a number line. Here is 10 and here is 11. So, 10.72 is closer to 11 than to 10. Gets? Our next lesson is subsets of real numbers.